Alright, hello everyone and welcome back to my Fallout 4 Mod Spotlight series, where today we are having a look at the pottery mod, which is being made by user Zorkaz. And what this glorious little piece of work looks at into the game is the ability to make your own pottery. And this is of course yet another of the profession mods being added in by Zorkaz, which give you an alternative means of making money in the world besides going around murdering everything in the Commonwealth. And I have very much enjoyed these mods, and this one in particular, as the pottery of course can be sold or used as a nice aesthetic piece of decoration around your settlement. Now, how do you make said pottery? Well, it's pretty simple. You just need to go into the workshop mode and head on over to the crafting category, where we have two new workstations. The first is the pottery station, and this is where you'll actually make the raw pottery, which you can then put into a pottery oven to add different colors to them and actually increase the value. As the basic raw pottery is not worth a whole lot, but colored, it will give you quite a bit more. But it will require more science to be able to do so, and I very much like that. Now, of course, to make the raw pottery, you are gonna need clay, and this mod works in tandem with another one of Zorkaz's mods, the basic mining mod, which adds into the world clay deposits, which you can mine, well, for of course clay, and then use it here with the pottery station to make the pottery. So let's go and take a look at the process. So let's go to the pottery station here, and when we go in, we're gonna get a loud sound of, I guess, the potter's wheel here spinning up. There it goes. It goes away in a moment, so you don't have to worry about that thing going forever. And we have two different categories here. The basic pottery category, which is your basic bog standard raw pottery. And then we have a collection of vanilla pottery that already exists in the world that you can just go ahead and make. Now in the craft basic pottery, we have a clay bowl, a ceramic bowl, a cup, another kind of cup, a pitcher, a plate, and a teapot. Now you'll notice all of them have a value of about one, as well a just raw clay bowl isn't exactly worth much. And like I said, it will then increase in value when you put it into the oven. And each of them will take three clay, no matter which it is that you're making, to actually be created. Now, in the vanilla pottery, these are, again, the different pieces of ceramic that exist in the world. So we have an empty floral barrel vase, a floral bud vase, floral flared vase, a floral rounded vase, a vaulted vase, and then we go to teal variety of the same, and then willow variety of the same, and then we also get a saucer, a teacup, a teapot, and a vase. And each of these also only takes three to produce, but what you may notice is down here in the, well, the recycle bit, what you'd get if you broke it down into the junk. Well, it's working off of the standard values for these, as these are vanilla objects, which for things like these different vases, it kind of makes sense. Three clay into two ceramic, that's not too crazy. A saucer is a small thing, so it's only gonna have one ceramic. The vase now will give you three ceramic, but what I think is a little bit off is the teapot. It also, of course, takes three clay to produce, but will give you five ceramic and an asbestos. Which, of course, again, this is a vanilla teapot that already exists in the game, so that's just what it defaults to when you recycle it. So, yeah, that's not really the mod's fault, but at the very least, maybe, you know, the mod could increase the amount of clay that you need to make it, so that it doesn't seem so strange that you're getting so much back in return. Now, let's go and leave the potter station, where our camera is unfortunately gonna get kicked into third-person mode here in a moment. I don't know why it does this, but it does it every time you leave the potter station, as well as the pottery oven over here. But let's actually go back into first person mode and head over here to all of the different pottery, so you can see it in the world. Now, these ones that are just kind of rough and orange, these are the raw clay items. So we have the pitcher there, the plate, the ceramic bowl, the normal bowl, and the two different cups. And then we have the teapot here, sitting next to the vanilla teapot, which is much fancier, just so you can see the difference between the two. And then, of course, here are all of the different vanilla ceramic items that you can also make, including the teacup and tea saucer, which if you, play around with it, you can actually get the cup on the saucer, but it takes some finagling, as usually kind of rolls off of it. But yes, it is possible. And so these are all of the things you can make. Now, I should point out, we also get two lovely signs, a pottery sign and a fine pottery sign, which if we jump back into the workshop mode real quick, is in decorations and then over in the miscellaneous category where you can find them right here. So we have the sign and the other sign. Always fun to have. Now, you can see these lovely colored tea kettles up here, and those are the things we can then create with the pottery oven. So let's go over to that, and again, when we jump into this, it's gonna make another overly loud sound of the fire starting up, so fair warning. There we go, that's a little bit too loud, a little bit too loud. But yes, in here we can turn our various raw bits of pottery into either red, white, or blue pottery. Now the red is the most basic, only requiring rank 2 in science. The white pottery will then require rank 3 in science, and the blue pottery will require rank 4 in science. And what you may have noticed, the value's also going up. So for the red pottery, this ceramic bowl is only worth 7, which is up from the 1 value it had before. White pottery, it is up to 9, and then the blue pottery is up to 19. So once you get to the rank 4 in science, you're gonna really crank out, I mean, not a whole lot of money, but yeah, change. It's change at least. Now, other than the ceramic bowl itself, there are no other requirements. You're just taking the various raw clay objects and firing them here in the oven with a required amount of science. And in return, you will get back a new piece with a different color and a higher value. And that is pretty cool. I really do like the whole process. It adds just a fun new thing for you to do in the game to make a little bit of money. And again, I mean, oh, there we go. We got kicked back out into third person. Yeah, that one's a little bit delayed. I don't know why, but it takes a little bit. But yeah, it's a lovely little mod that gives you not only a way to make money, but also a fun new decorative object to put into the world. Though, I actually just realized I need to mention one more thing. Now, when you do have these different pieces of pottery in your inventory, just to give you an idea of where they go, the raw clay objects, they will actually go into your miscellaneous area in here. There's the clay teapot. But once you do fire it in the oven, it'll actually go into the junk category because it can actually be junked for material. We can turn this tea kettle now into a piece of ceramic. The raw items cannot be recycled. They are just raw clay pottery items. But once you do fire them and make them nicer, they can then be turned into ceramic for your settlements. But yeah, that is all I really got to say on the mod. It is a lovely little piece of work that just, it's nice to have more options for making money and decoration. So if you'd like to check this mod out for yourself, which I would certainly recommend you go and do, you can have a look at the link in the description as per usual. But that is going to be it for today, my friends. I hope you all have enjoyed and that you do come back for the next episode. But until that time, thank you for watching. And as always, have a good one.